Hey, good evening. Puerto is in the morning, right? Are you? Hey, Zivix. You feel like I have time to play games? My game time is making YouTube right now. But I do watch a lot of StarCraft 2. I say watching StarCraft 2 is pretty much just my entertainment right now. Like Nintendo games, retro games. Hello, Kitsu. I don't know who I'm drawing. I'm just drawing a random girl that I really like this sketch of the reference. Mm-hmm. Hi, bro. Abarikokwako. Abarikark. Do you have pets? I don't have pets. Oh, new name? Oh, you have a cold too? Me too. It's cold season. Yeah, you can be my Twitter friends. What's the definition of Twitter friends? I just finished freerun today. So I'm back to Jujutsu Kaisen now. Hello. Hey, Akash. Doing well. How about you? I'll check on my Twitter DM. Are you Korean? Hello. I can't read any of the stuff you post. I got a book, so I'm trying to follow what you are doing. Right now, I'm just doing fun things and hang out with you guys. So, not very structural. Hopefully, I don't screw this one up. Yeah, I love Korean webtoon artists. I think Korean artists are now better than Japanese. Now I realize this reference proportion is a little wrong. No wonder I was doing like, why? It's not right. gotta go from here. Big leap. Hopefully I don't screw it up. Hey, Juzo. Crazy Apple, how are you? Neoname. Do you live in Korea right now? Hello, AJ. No time, no see. How have you been? Crazy Apple, where are you from again? Hi, Mr. P. We got a lot of new faces today. Welcome. This 005 is not doing me any good. Mr. P, where are you from? What's B doing your research? AJ, what degree are you studying? Oh, great. Love, we are drawing all together. What do you draw? Thanks, Niu Neng, for being my friend. Computer science. Computer science seems like a good degree. Hey, Kanamli. Actually, today's it was a lecture that took 45 minutes, and then I had to correct the last drawing. It did made some corrections, so it's this time already. Just say no study today. For some reason, I'm not quite used to this streaming Monday, Wednesday, Friday tempo. I feel like back then I was streaming almost daily. I was less stressful than now. I'm streaming Monday, Wednesday, Friday. For some reason. I'm glad to get to know you too, Neo Ning. Glad to get to know everyone. So what's going on in Korea nowadays? I realize this is an AI reference photo when I'm start drawing hands. Mm-hmm. whatever, it's that perfect. But then some of the proportions were off. Thank you, Corey Ho. Yeah, I think that's the idea. Yeah, everyone just join the string and draw. And we can chat and hang out. Calamity, do I still draw for the rest of the week? Yes. So initially the idea was that when I started, I was doing, my tempo was almost like pretty much as long as I'm free, I streaming every night. So I was like streaming almost daily. So when I do that, the next day I have the material to make YouTube shorts. I pretty much just convert my long form into YouTube shorts. And then I thought, well, maybe let me just don't stream every night. Use the offline nights. Work on some of the things I want to do myself. Like work on my stories, like that, digital art. But now I don't make that much more progress on the off nights. And then the next day I don't have my short video material. So that kind of puts me in a stress mode, even though there's nothing to stress about. But that's what YouTube does to you. I post what I draw on Twitter. So far, out of all the social platforms, YouTube is the only platform that I kind of figured out how to grow organically. And then, so I was doing Instagram for 4 years. Never figured out how to grow organically. And then I switched to Twitter X, still the same. But when I started to to YouTube, and I pretty much YouTube become my primary, then everything else is secondary. And now my Instagram start to grow, my TikTok growing organically. progress, you mean like when I say no progress, I meant like no growth on Instagram or pretty much any social platform. Whatever growth that you see I have on the other social platform, none of those are from organic growth. I rarely have any organic growth. It was like one brief moment thinking 2021, there was one brief moment where I post on Instagram. I went on to the feature page and I got like 600 likes. That was like the best day of my Instagram days. But even I get 600 likes, I don't gain that many followers. And then ever since Instagram decided to promote Reels, the entire photo or still image session just die. Like every time you post something, you don't get any interaction. Yet I feel like it's like they're not, for some reason that I just feel like the content is not getting out there, because like if the content actually gets out there, then I do have interactions. I feel like it's the platform they want to control the exposure. So when they send my content out, then I got a bunch of interaction, and then it's like you turn off the faucet, then you turn off and then boom, everything stops. So obviously there are people like my content, because when they push it out, I do get interactions. But then when they stop pushing it out, then it's just crickets. So never crack the code on that one. So from both like Instagram, X, it's a lot of you join this art support community and everyone does the like follow for follow, shout shout out for shout out, like everyone support each other, but it's pretty disingenuous support. Like I support the posts that have like absolute no interest in supporting, but because I'm part of this group, they're supporting me, so I gotta support them, even though like I have no interest in their work. So when I started YouTube, I just say I'm not gonna do any of that. I'm just gonna do my thing, and if people like my stuff, then they follow me. If they don't, then I'm still gonna do my thing. Can I follow you? I'm sorry, I can't follow you. If that makes you want to unfollow me, you can go ahead. I only follow things that actually I'm interested in follow. What's the definition of scummy? Hey, Felix. Doing well. Just a little bit under the weather. But can't complain. Tips for drawing hair. Do not draw the hair strand. I think I definitely fell into that trap. And a lot of beginners fell into that trap. Yeah, but don't draw individual hair strand. Draw the shape, the hair shape. And you only need to work out small details in the hair. You draw the overall big shapes and then just like touch up on the little details and the whole hair will come out. Neo name, you do good work. Shrink this down a little. Hey, Bang Yong. Sorry. Is that Xia or Swan? My Chinese is lacking. Nope, not shy, not strong. Ling? Oh, Ling, yeah, Wang Yong Ling. Hey, Wang Yong Ling, 早上好. So when I draw, what are the kind of thoughts that go through my head when building? So for things like this, I'm just copying. It's very little things that go in my head because the design work is already done. So design is the hard part. So pretty much I just follow the line work. If the design work's already done, I mostly just focus on the relationship. Actually, like to the teacher that I'm actually taking a class from, and then the teacher I purchased the book from, both of them say, when we draw, when we do art, we are drawing relationships. So that's what art it's about. Just the building relationship. The relationship between shapes, between color, contrast, values. So like when I'm copying, I basically just try my best to pay attention to the relationship of the lines. But obviously it will be error, not an error-free process. Most of the error comes from the angle. I'm a Chinese. Hopefully. Where are you from? Wyoming? I try my best to understand that. I think the key part is just draw. This is with learning a lot of things. In the beginning, it's more do, less learn. I will say 10% learning, 90% do in the beginning. Then the more skill you become, to improve, you switch gradually into more learn, less do. Taiwan is a good place. Never been to Taiwan before. Are you an artist in Taiwan? Taiwan got some amazing artists. Yes, I live in Florida. Who live closest to me? I mean, Northeast Florida. Oh, it's out of R as something you would be great at if you could grasp or understand a sentence. It must be actually. Yeah, sometimes there's different types of understanding, or different levels of understanding. There's very superficial level, like you understand the concept in your head, and then the next understanding is you can repeat that understanding, you can repeat it, regurgitate it. But then the next one is you can actually teach that concept to others. And then you transcend into application, different scenarios. So I think, understanding at a superficial level doesn't help that much. Because I definitely have watched a lot of videos, read a lot of books. Like when the books or the video convey information to you in your head, you say it makes sense. But you actually didn't know that. The best way to learn, I've found it, is that you have to do it through your own deductive reasoning. You have to go through that exercise. Like pretty much like right now, I'm just copying the reference. I'm no way learning anything on the reference. But if I take the reference away and start to pondering and draw something like the reference without looking at the reference, and then go back and check my answer, then that process would definitely help me learn much, much more efficiently. Yeah, the best way to test your next level of understanding is to just take the reference away and see if you can draw from memory. And once you can draw from memory, that's a very big upgrade. Because when I was learning human proportions, I watch a lot of videos about proportions, and every time when I watch it, I thought I understood it, but when I come to draw, I still face the same problem. Not until I start to memorize the proportions. And once I memorize the proportions, and and start draw the proportions on paper from memory. And then when I'm doing drawings, I can actually put those skills in use. And I can check on proportions. Neon name, right now it's supposedly Friday. Yeah, my schedule is Monday, Wednesday, Friday. Hello, Brandon from Colombia, where they make great coffee. Do you drink coffee every day? Colombia coffee is amazing. I don't understand that. Fevroir, can someone translate that? This has sent me onto a complete new anisome. Oh, thank you. Thank you for your kind words. So what is your art goal? I think that's important to understand. We do be able to replicate and measure from finished JSPEG. Can't. Oh, replica from an image from your head to a paper, that's a very tough skill to master. Just say heads up, that's not an easy task. Even the greatest artists in human history can't even do that. When they draw, they still use model. And they use model and they use lighting. They use like sets. They set up the model in a set with costumes and tools, weapons when they draw. So you think about the greatest artists of all time can't even draw from imagination. No. So just understand the goal that you set for yourself. Also understand there's a difference between draw from imagination versus just draw something that you have done it before, so you have build that into your visual library, and you are basically regurgitating something from memory. So that's not drawing from imagination, that's just draw from memory. So that one is easier to achieve, you just have to draw a lot. Thank you, Neil Ning. I do like coffee. I drink coffee every day. The product I use, they often label Colombia coffee. Hey, I didn't flop on this one. I think this one turned out fairly okay. See you next stream, Crazy Apple. Maybe I put some color on her. Thank you. That's a good idea. How do I say your name? Kui? Kui? Blue Christy. Hello? Co. Okay. Co. Let's try another one. I probably don't have time to draw another one. Well, I just leave this here. So I actually already have a Discord server. It's just not open to the public. Let me see if I... Well, let's just say if we have time now, let's just take the time and do one. Where's my Discord? Thank you, Dark. Thank you for the support. So my Discord server is called the Q Clan. What do I do? How do I share my Discord server? Can do it here. Hi, Co. Well, we have Co. That's cool. GR33NHOOTI. Wait to say hi. Right now, I don't want to monetize. Just everyone enjoy. I think my rule of monetization is completely voluntary. So I won't have any content locked behind a paywall. Hey, Rakieta. Hello. Oh, really? Co, are you a experienced Discord user? Hello, Jefferson. Yeah, what does your server do? Yeah, show me your server. Hi, who's Sam? Thank you. Yeah, I'm doing traditional art because I can't make it. And the digital art, too much competition. Yeah, Co, you can help me. You definitely know more than this. You know more about Discord than me. But just because I'm not monetized, so you are also a volunteer. We do it for the love of the love for the game. That's cool. Hmm. So what do I need to do? What role do I have to make you? No role. Do I even have roles created? Permissions. Events permissions. Role member. I meet. I just have to be a mod, okay? Step number one, how do I make you a mod? Okay, cool. So I think I've set some permissions. No, that's in the general text channel. Who's Sam? Hi. Roles. Create roles. Mod. Thank you. When you create a role, go to permission, scroll all the way down. It's the administration one. So the administrator one, that's the one pretty much lets you do everything, right? Remember, with this permission, we'll have every permission and we'll also bypass all channel-specific permission or restrictions. For example, this member will get access to all private channels. Edit or delete channel. Okay. Okay, cool. So you have admin permission now. Let's go. Okay, I'm going to bed now. And hopefully when I wake up, I have an awesome Discord server. Yeah, make the rules like everyone be nice, no spamming, no advertising, promotion, just safe, healthy discussion about art. Let's just make that a rule. Well, I think we made a lot of progress today. Got our Discord server established and got some members. That's pretty exciting. But I gotta go to bed now, and you guys have a great night. Bye-bye.